Any star, it will run out of fuel in its core, and it starts changing, it starts bloating, and getting so large that it will engulf the orbit of Mercury and Venus and come very close to Earth. So imagine looking on the horizon, and sunrise is half the sky.
Minutes ago, the James Webb telescope saw a shocking 250% jump in Betelgeuse's brightness, making scientists sit up and take notice. This giant red star, known for its strange behavior, is shining brighter than ever, raising questions about what's coming next. Is this a sign that Betelgeuse is about to explode? We might be closer to witnessing a spectacular event with every change in its light. Let's explore what this sudden, deadly brightness could mean for our planet. Is a supernova coming? Just like every star, Betelgeuse will eventually run out of fuel. But when it does, it won't just quietly fade away. Instead, it will swell up and become unstable, leading to a dramatic end. The big question is, when will this happen? It could be tomorrow, or it could take thousands of years. One thing's for sure, though. When it finally erupts, the entire universe will notice. Betelgeuse will run out of fuel and explode. Tomorrow, or in thousands of years. One thing's for sure. When it erupts, the universe will notice. We may see it or miss it. Betelgeuse is a massive red supergiant located on the shoulder of the Orion constellation. And recently, it did something surprising. It became 50% brighter. This sudden change has caught the attention of astronomers everywhere. The James Webb Space Telescope, JWST, has been keeping a close watch on Betelgeuse and recently recorded this dramatic rise in brightness. Usually, Betelgeuse is a familiar sight in the night sky, easy to spot in Orion. But now it's glowing brighter than ever, becoming the seventh brightest star we can see. This isn't just a small flicker, it's a major shift, suggesting something might be changing inside the star. Its sudden burst of light could be a sign of changes in its size, temperature, or even how it releases energy. But here's the thing, even though Betelgeuse is acting strangely, we can't be sure when it will explode. If it does, the explosion would be one of the brightest things we'd ever see in the night sky. It could even outshine the moon and be visible during the day. Scientists and sky watchers alike are eagerly looking for any signs that could give us a hint about when this might happen. For centuries, Betelgeuse has been a star of interest. People have watched it brighten and dim, and it's been part of myths and stories across different cultures. Until recently, it followed a regular cycle of brightening and dimming every 400 days. But now, that cycle has shortened to just 13 days, leaving astronomers puzzled. Could this change mean something fundamental inside the star is shifting? This taught scientists a lot about what goes on in the outer layers of stars like Betelgeuse. The star had a massive surface eruption, sending out enough dust to hide its light. It wasn't the end of the star, but it gave astronomers a rare chance to learn more about how stars behave as they get older. Imagine if Betelgeuse were placed at the center of our solar system. It's so large it would swallow Earth, Mars, and even Jupiter. Its massive size plays a big role in its unpredictable nature. Because it's so huge, the outer layers of the star are loosely held together, making it unstable. This instability causes Betelgeuse to flicker, sometimes growing brighter and sometimes dimmer. These flickers are part of what makes Betelgeuse so interesting to astronomers. Inside the star, giant bubbles of gas rise and fall, bringing hot gas to the surface and changing its brightness. Each shift in brightness gives scientists clues about what's going on inside, helping them better understand how stars like Betelgeuse live and die. Modern telescopes like the Hubble Space Telescope and the Very Large Telescope, VLT, are helping astronomers unlock more secrets of Betelgeuse. Each of these telescopes brings something different to the table. The JWST can look through the dust around the star, revealing hidden structures. The Hubble telescope tracks changes in Betelgeuse's size and activity. The VLT captures detailed images of the star's light. But what does all of this mean for us? It's possible that these telescopes, working together, will give us a clearer picture of when Betelgeuse might finally reach its end. When the supernova does happen, the first thing to escape will be neutrinos, tiny particles that can reach Earth before the light from the explosion does. Scientists around the world have detectors ready to catch these particles. When they do, it will be a signal that the supernova is imminent. Can you imagine looking up at the sky and seeing a light so bright it casts shadows at night? This could happen when Betelgeuse explodes. For a few weeks, it could outshine Venus and be visible even during the day. But don't worry, Betelgeuse is far enough away that the explosion won't harm Earth. Instead, it will be one of the most amazing sights we'll ever see. A rare and breathtaking event in the night sky. As Betelgeuse gets brighter, the universe is paying attention. What will happen next? A supernova could light up our sky. The big event that will catch everyone's attention on Earth won't be due to any danger from space. Instead, it's the amazing light show that will fill the night sky. This stunning display will be like nothing we've ever seen before, giving people everywhere a rare chance to see a piece of cosmic history. Betelgeuse, a giant star, is going through big changes, and scientists are using this rare moment to learn more about how stars live and die. By watching its unusual behavior, we can discover more about how stars evolve and explode, helping us better understand how the universe works. Back in 2019, astronomers noticed something strange. Betelgeuse, one of the brightest stars in the sky, started to dim in a big way. It wasn't just a little flicker. It was a major drop in brightness, something no one had seen before. Stars do change in brightness naturally, but this was different. Betelgeuse lost a big chunk of its light, leaving scientists puzzled. Then, just as suddenly as it dimmed, the star began to shine brightly again. Researchers were left wondering what had happened, eager to find out more. With the help of the Hubble Space Telescope, scientists confirmed that Betelgeuse had ejected a huge amount of material from its surface. This was something they had never seen from a star like this before, making it a groundbreaking discovery. The eruption caused the dimming effect that we saw on Earth. But what did this mean? Was Betelgeuse about to explode in a supernova? To understand what might happen to Betelgeuse, we need to know what happens to big stars when they run out of fuel. For most of its life, a star keeps a balance between the force of gravity pulling in and the pressure of heat pushing out. But when it uses up its fuel, that balance is lost. This leads to a massive explosion called a supernova, which is one of the most powerful events in the universe. The outer parts of the star are blasted into space, while the core collapses, sometimes forming a neutron star or even a black hole. But this isn't the worst part. What happens after the explosion? Supernovae play a huge role in spreading essential elements like carbon, oxygen, and iron across space. These elements are needed for new stars, planets, and even life itself to form. In fact, many of the elements that make up our bodies were created in such explosions billions of years ago. Every supernova helps us learn more about the life and death of stars and the history of the universe. So what if Betelgeuse does go supernova? Should we be worried here on Earth? The short answer is no. Betelgeuse, while big and bright, is about 600 light years away. That's far enough that even the powerful explosion of a supernova wouldn't hurt us. The light from the blast would be incredibly bright, possibly lighting up the night sky for weeks. But that's all. It would just be a spectacular sight, with no harm to life on Earth. Because of its distance, we're safely outside the danger zone. A supernova would need to happen within about 30 light years of Earth to cause any serious problems. Luckily, Betelgeuse is far enough away that, while the explosion will be amazing to see, it won't be dangerous. Instead, we'll get to enjoy one of the most incredible light shows in the universe, visible to the naked eye. But don't get too excited just yet. The exact timing of Betelgeuse's explosion is still a mystery. While we know it will happen eventually, it could be in the next few thousand years, or it could happen tomorrow. Stars live on much longer timescales than humans. So even though Betelgeuse is nearing the end of its life, it's unclear when it will actually explode. Whenever it does happen, though, it will be a moment to remember. It will be the first time in centuries that a supernova will be visible from Earth without a telescope. Scientists are keeping a close eye on Betelgeuse, watching for any signs that the big explosion might be coming soon. The strange dimming back in 2019 has only added to the excitement, as it could be a hint of bigger things to come. But for now, all we can do is keep looking up at the night sky and wait for one of the universe's greatest spectacles to unfold. In the TRAPPIST-1 system, there is a group of seven planets, each about the same size as Earth, that orbits a small, quiet red star. This star system is only 40 light years away from us, making it a big focus in our quest to learn more about the universe. Out of these seven planets, three are in what we call the habitable zone. This area could allow for liquid water, which is a key ingredient for life. Finding these planets is exciting because where there's water, there might also be life. The star itself is quite unique. Even though this red dwarf star is much smaller and cooler than our sun, it still gives off enough light that life could possibly exist on its planets. Scientists are looking deeper into the universe with powerful tools like the JWST to understand these faraway worlds. However, they often face big challenges, especially when studying planets like Proxima B. With a big explosion possible, how will Betelgeuse change what we know about stars? James Webb Telescope searches for life on Proxima B. Proxima B orbits Proxima Centauri, which is only 4.25 light years away. This planet is hard to study because it's very close to its star, and intense bursts of energy from the star make it difficult to get clear data or images. These bursts mess with the signals, making it tough to learn much about this planet. But with the advanced technology of the JWST, there's hope. This telescope can pick up faint signs of life, like the glow from city lights or the presence of an atmosphere, which could give us more clues about Proxima B. The JWST is opening new doors in our exploration of space. It might help us find evidence that changes everything we know about the universe. As we continue to develop more powerful telescopes, the chances for new discoveries increase. For example, the extremely large telescope, expected to start working in the mid-2020s, will be able to look closely at the atmospheres of planets far from Earth. It could even detect chemicals that point to the presence of life, like ozone, giving us strong proof that other habitable places exist. But this isn't the most challenging part. As we push further in our quest for knowledge, we face even deeper questions. Are we alone in the universe? Or is life out there more common than we've ever imagined? Discovering life on other planets could have a huge impact on how we think about our place in the universe. If we find life elsewhere, it would force us to rethink humanity's role. If not, it could make us realize just how unique and special our existence is. The JWST is not just a scientific tool, it's a symbol of humanity's search for answers. Launched on Christmas Day in 2021, it has state-of-the-art technology that allows scientists to look far into space and back in time. Its advanced infrared sensors can capture light that has traveled billions of years to reach us, giving us a glimpse of the universe as it was in its early days. But that's not the only surprising thing. One of the most amazing abilities of the JWST is its power to see objects that are extremely far away and faint, things that were invisible even to the Hubble Space Telescope. Its massive mirror, which is 6.5 meters wide, collects much more light than Hubble could, offering us sharper and more detailed views of the cosmos. One of its standout features is its ability to see in infrared light. This allows it to look through thick clouds of gas and dust, showing us places where stars and planets are being born. By studying distant planets' atmospheres in infrared, scientists can look for signs of life, like traces of chemicals that living things might produce, such as ozone. But things get even stranger. Physicist Michio Kaku recently pointed out that some of the galaxies the JWST has observed seem much older than expected. In fact, the number of ancient galaxies is surprising. These discoveries suggest galaxies formed much earlier than we thought. This raises new questions about the Big Bang theory which says the universe started with a massive explosion and has been expanding ever since. But here's the puzzling part. Galaxies far away should look smaller because their light stretches as they move away from us. However, the galaxies seen by the JWST don't seem to be shrinking as we'd expect. They appear almost the same size as galaxies closer to us, which leads to more questions about how the universe is expanding. But that's not the weirdest discovery. The telescope has also captured images of galaxies that look way too smooth and orderly. According to current theories, galaxies should have looked more chaotic, especially when they were first forming. Yet these galaxies seem calm and neatly arranged, which contradicts what we thought about how galaxies evolved over time. But this wasn't the strangest part. The telescope has even spotted stars that seem older than the universe itself. Our current models tell us the universe is about 13.8 billion years old, yet some stars look over a billion years older than that. If these stars really existed before the universe began, we'd have to completely rethink everything we know about the origins of space and time. These findings bring up deep questions about how time and space really work. Some scientists are now wondering if time might not exist the way we think it does. Instead, time might be more like a dimension where everything, past, present, and future, happens all at once. Each new discovery with the JWST gets us closer to answers, but also leaves us with even more mysteries to solve. Aren't just events that happened in the past or will happen in the future. According to some theories, these moments are part of a much bigger reality that combines time and space. This concept really makes you question how we think about life itself. If the future is already set and fixed, what does that say about our ability to make choices, set goals, or have hopes? What happens to our fears or dreams for what's to come? Can we still make decisions if everything is already written? These thoughts don't just change how we see the universe, but also challenge how we see ourselves. In this light, the idea of free will becomes complicated, as does our purpose. If we're not moving through time, but instead placed in it like a landscape, it challenges everything we thought we knew. But this isn't even the most mind-boggling part. The more we dig into these questions, the more we realize our universe might operate in ways that are far stranger than anything we've ever considered. The answers to these big questions could be beyond what we can even imagine, urging us to keep searching and questioning. As we look up at the stars, we can't help but wonder what lies beyond. The most advanced tool we have for finding out is the JWST. Launched in December 2021, it's taking over from the Hubble Space Telescope, but JWST is much more powerful. With its giant mirror, 6.5 meters across, much larger than Hubble's, JWST can capture a lot more light. This means we can see deeper into space and further back in time than ever before. One of JWST's coolest features is that it can see in infrared light. This allows it to look through clouds of space dust that block visible light. Thanks to this, we can now see parts of the universe that have been hidden, learning more about how stars, galaxies, and planets form. But here's where things get even more interesting. JWST is on a mission to answer some of the biggest questions we have about the universe. It will study planets in our solar system, look at faraway worlds around other stars, and explore the structures that hold the universe together. These goals aren't just ambitious. They'll likely keep JWST a critical part of space research for a long time. As we await Betelgeuse's spectacular fate, one question remains. Are we ready for the cosmic show, or do we fear the unknown? Like and subscribe for more mind-bending explorations.